Bonjour, bonjour, fragrance lovers, this is Clémence, I talk about fragrance, welcome back. A totally improvised video. I was just doing some research about fragrance and I was like, do you know what? I've done fragrances that I saw drive men crazy and stuff like this. And I'm like, but what does internet say about this? So let me just have a look. So I've done a video like that, Lady Killer Fragrance. You can still have a look at that video. But today I'm just gonna see what's online says. And let's type, what we're gonna type? Women loves these fragrances. Ah, realmenrealstyle.com. Cologne woman love on men. 10 most attractive cologne. Let's have a look. Will she bury her face in your neck and say, you smell great? Right. Or will she wrinkle her nose and pull away? She's not very nice if she's doing that. Whether she's your wife or the girl you just met, she's the most important critic of your cologne. Well, that's true, but I would say it's important that you like your things too, you know? Number 10 is Dolce & Gabbana Light Blue. Fresh, crisp, clean, aquatic. It's nice. I like it. I really like it, but I won't say it drives me crazy. It's a nice freshie. I really enjoy light blue. Like, I don't think freshies drive women completely mad. It depends. I like Acqua di Parma, for example, freshies. I think they're so sexy, especially Colonia Intensa. Number 9, Bulgari Man in Black. That is really nice. It does taste very long. I have to say I really enjoy this one. I think we're just gonna have designer in this list, but anyway, that's, you know, I have a bit of rum in this one, so it's a nice fragrance. Tom Ford Noir, yeah, sophisticated, a bit more sophisticated, definitely. Dolce & Gabbana The One, nice as well. It's very popular though. Those kind of scents, I've seen them again and again and again, so it kind of losing its charm. Like, I would say, I think ladies like something that stands out now, and that's why we have niche fragrance. They like something a bit more unique, you know? Gucci Guilty Eau Pour Homme. Oh no, oh no. Sorry. I don't really like that. It's an alpha male scent. Really? I thought it was like pretty light as well. It's nothing special, this one. Bear in mind in this video, that's just my subjective. Tom Ford Grey Vetiver. Oh, thank God. Yes, one of the best vetiver. Very formal. It's nice for office. I love this one. I really love Tom Ford anyway. I think on men it's very flattering. They always have that provocative tone. So if you want to charm the ladies, Tom Ford, guys, definitely. If you want something elegant as when vetiver is the best ingredient, so really nice. Kenneth Cole, Mannequin Hero. I don't know this. So Amouage Reflection Man. Yes. You know why I agree? Because this is really unique. It's got a floral tone, and floral tone on men is super alluring. It's not really sexy, it's more romantic, and I feel like this is what drives ladies crazy. That's my opinion, but alpha male is great, but if you have like someone sensitive to talk with, it's nice too. More romantic, and that drives lady crazy. It's like, who doesn't like a Titanic moment?
You what? So,
not when they're sinking though, like when it's actually nice. He's got delicacy, really something luminous. I love Reflection Man. I so agree with that. Another one, Versace Eros. No, like not for me, not in my world. I mean, that's a nice scent, you know, but I feel it's very young. It's very too young for me. So I would give it for me to a teenager or maybe a young man, you know, for summer or clubbing scent. Yeah, I don't think it's that crazy attractive though. Well, maybe for younger people. I'm maybe too old. I'm too old to understand. Oh no. Okay, let's go to another website. The Gentleman Journal.com. 10 men's fragrance that women love. Okay, that's perfect. That's what we're looking for. Aqua di Parma Colonia. Hey, that's good. Oh, this one is so elegant. It's timeless. There's something a bit more warm inside, slightly leathery, and I really love that. Especially the Intensa. It's so sexy on men. Drive me mad all the time. It's really that Italian cliche fragrance. Love it. Really love it. I think Terre d'Hermès. Yeah. I mean, yeah, it's one of my favorite designer scents. My favorite designer scent, I think. Vetiver, punchy, casual chic. Like, it's a bit more like that sporty man, but very elegant. Always working Terre d'Hermès. Always working on ladies as well. Yeah, I agree 100%. Dolce & Gabbana pour homme. I prefer that, actually, pour homme. It's nice because it's more tobacco-like. So anything with tobacco, amber, something darker, I think tends to drive more women crazy, in my opinion. But yeah. Floris number 89. Oh my God. What's this thing? Gentleman Journal. Guys, gentlemen, I think this website is amazing. If you put Floris number 89 in there, you understood everything. Number 89 is the James Bond of the fragrance. Floris is so refined, Floris is so elegant, and that's what we want to like. We want to see gentlemen, and this is what drives people crazy. Why is James Bond is so popular to ladies? because voilà. Everything from Floris is nice, and I would say even more Honeywood from Floris. If you want something ultra seductive and sexy from them, you're gonna love it. Okay, Penaligans. Okay, they just said Penaligans. Well, I would say Alfetti if you're looking for Penaligans. Yeah. Chanel Allure Homme Sport. Yes, sure. That's a really nice marine type of scent. It does usually work because it works on anyone, I would say, and it's really easy to wear. I prefer from Chanel the Egoist, more deeper, like warmer. To play it safe, I would go Coromandel. Oh, very unique, very oriental, a bit mysterious. That will work. Jean-Paul Gaultier Le Male. Yeah, it's always work for me. Ladies love Le Male, you know? So, I agree with that. Gucci Guilty. I don't... That's the only one I'm like, however, I think this article have done a really good job. Really, really good job. So well done, the Gentleman's Journal. Oh, Vogue.co.uk, perfect chemistry. How women want men to smell. That's interesting. Apparently women like Vetiver, Cashmere, Cigar, Soapy. I agree with Vetiver, Cashmere, because it's cozy, it's comforting. That's what lady wants to have, somebody that can secure them, you know? Not in financial way, of course, like we all independent ladies, come on, it's 20th century. We don't need a man. but you like to feel secure with the person you are. So I think Cashmere, musky, warm fragrance feel... You know, you feel secure to me. That's why I like fragrance like Dior Homme Intense, because it's secure and enveloping. How can a man express his virility while adopting the supposedly feminine practice of scenting himself? Very complex sentence, and that's a bit weird for something in the 20th century, no? Not too sure about this article. Sorry, Vogue, I love you, but... 20 women, how they feel when men wear or don't wear cologne. Their response varies. Smell is very important, but it doesn't have to be a cologne. As long as you wear deodorant and show you make an effort to stay fresh, that's what counts. Ah, no. A man not wearing a fragrance, for me, it's a disgrace. Like, it's your invisible accessory. That's what's finishing the look. It gives personality. For me, colognes means you're a man. It's a turn on. Wow. Okay, that's full on, Elizabeth. I love the smell of cologne and once kept a guy's sweater extra long because it smells so good. Is that weird? No, I've done it before. That's okay. depending on the cologne, I love when men wear it. I'm not a fan of cologne. Okay. I do like when guys have a good cologne. That way, if I smell it randomly on someone, I think of them. That's true, man. Once we smell it on you, it's your scent. And we will forever think about you with this scent. And that's why it's important to have a fragrance. That's why it's not good to also wear the fragrance of her ex-boyfriend. Because she already associates this fragrance to the ex-boyfriend.
To me, you know.
Makes sense to me. Yes, but not too much. It shows you take care of yourself. Definitely. Definitely. It shows that you want to... Not that you want to seduce. It shows that you like to treat yourself and you just enjoy, like, you know, to take care of yourself. It's important. I'm a fan of a cologne in moderation if it isn't too overpowering. Besides, if your clothes smell like they've been getting stale in the back of your closet, that's a huge turn off. Oh, honestly, Becky, I do really agree. And do you know it's the trend of bismuth? I'm not too sure us ladies are that fan of bismuth. Well, in my term as well, I don't really like when the fragrance on men is too overpowering. I don't like when it's straight in my face. I like it to smell, to have a nice sillage that I can smell him, but not when he's like overbearing. That's why I don't really enjoy things like Sauvage or 1 Million, because I think it's too much, but that's my opinion. Yes, but make an effort not to buy the kind every other guy has. Always awkward when you're on a date or hooking up with someone who smells like your ex. Thank you, Lisa. Exactly. That's why you need to go for more unique smell to me. You're sure that we're not associating you with our ex-boyfriends. Overall, I can see there's so many girls that says that they like a cologne. They like it to be quite warm, enveloping, sometimes fresh, clean, for maybe like every day. They don't like it to be overpowering, as I can read. There's a lot of people that says, yeah, not too overpowering. But most of them really love a cologne on a man. Oh yeah, scents are very evocative. I'm constantly reminded of ex-boyfriend when I pass a stranger, we wear the same cologne. Whether or not it's a good thing, one thing's for sure, it's unforgettable. And we're gonna finish on that comment from Sydney. Sydney, well done. That you wear fragrance to make yourself unforgettable. Anyway, I don't know if you like this video. It was slightly different from what I used to do. If you want to see my list of fragrances that drive men crazy, you've got it in the description box for you to have a look. So that's my personal list that I think drive women crazy. And we had some other opinion in there, so I hope it did help you. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, leave me a little like, and also everyone, thank you so much for going to my uTip in the description box to leave me a little contribution. It's always very much appreciated, and I will see you very soon. Bye now.